when he came up to the field, which he was leaving, we, okay, so he just sat there and leave a little extra for her.
So he had something in mind then?
Yeah, tell me that he was trying to catch her eye there, you know.
He had something in mind. He's just operating like a natural man. I see this beautiful woman down there. As a matter of fact, he came up, he said, who is this? Said, I'm an honorable man. I'm gonna find out who she is, cause she belongs to somebody. I'm gonna leave her alone.
But at the same time, also, don't you think Nelma had told Ruth about Boaz?
Yeah.
And she knew Boaz was a very wealthy man, and she knew who he was and all. And so Naomi was kind of orchestrating things from behind the scenes, kind of.
And she was. Yeah. And not only that.
She might have been working in the vein of a prophet.
Yeah. I think she had to be working on the name of the prophet.
Right.
Because of Jewish law,
exactly.
It would have been natural for her to tell him to go into that other camp. Right. Because he's got the right first to redeem him. And to redeem him, like.
I think even before they left the land of the Moabites, Ruth, when Orpah left, stayed behind. Naomi told them, she's too old to have children. You know, there's no way I'm going to, you know, don't wait around for me to have children, and so that you can marry one of them. It's not going to happen. So I think way back then, something, perhaps it was a plan of God for it to unfold the way it did.
It had to be the plan of God to unfold the way it did, because there was nothing in the law, nothing in the natural order that said it had to. The natural order would said it gone a different way. And even though the natural thing was God's law. So can that say that outside, you know, sometimes we think things have to go a certain way. And especially as Christians, okay, I heard the word and it's got to go just like this. But God can even work inside his word and take you a different direction. You can still go a different direction and still be in the word if you are listening to the voice of God. And only if you're listening to the voice of God.
the other kinsman, you know, for him it was option. But since he wasn't a brother to the dead husband, he was kind of down the line with his kinsman. So, and then by her being a Moabite, you know, that made it optional as well. If she hadn't been a Jewish woman, he'd have been more obligated, you know, to marry her, because she wasn't, you know, that was optional for him, so he chose not to. The boy is through that. So.
And even if it had been an option, there was a way out for him in the Jewish
way out.
He says, okay, I can just refuse to take her now.
Yeah.
She has the right to spit in my face and take the shoe off, but which was considered hers. But I still have a way out.
Yes.
God bless. Ready?